Welcome to this course on Basics of Electronics. In today's lecture, we shall discuss about electronic components. Before going to discuss about electronic components, we should know about this course. In this course, we shall discuss about electronic components and devices, measuring instruments, and circuits. Electronic components. Electronic components are broadly classified into two categories, passive components and active components. Resistors, capacitors, and inductors are considered as passive components, while semiconductor devices, tube devices are known as active components. Tube devices are further classified into vacuum tubes and gas tube. And semiconductor devices are junction diodes, bipolar junction transistors, fade effect transistors, UJTs, silicon controlled rectifiers, etc. Resistors. Every material resists the flow of electric current to some extent. Some materials offer very low resistance, such as copper and silver. These are called conductors. Some materials offer extremely high resistance, such as ceramic, wood, rubber. These are known as insulators. In electric and electronic circuits, there is a requirement of material with a specific value of resistance in the range between that of a conductor and an insulator. These materials are called resistors, and their values of resistance are expressed in ohms. Resistors are further classified into two categories, linear resistors and non-linear resistors. The resistors whose value changes with the applied voltage and temperature according to Ohm's law are called linear resistors. Linear resistors are further classified into two categories, fixed resistors and variable resistors. Example of fixed resistors are carbon composition, carbon film, metal film, wire wound. And example of variable resistors are potentiometer, rheostat, trimmers. Now you can see the carbon composition resistor on the screen. The cylindrical part is made from the mixture of carbon or graphite powder and ceramic in the portions needed for the desired resistance value. This resistance is widely used by electrical and electronic gadgets. It is available in few ohms to 100 mega ohms, and its power rating is about 2 volt. Carbon film resistors. It is manufactured by depositing a carbon film on a ceramic substrate. The approximate value of resistance is obtained by either trimming the layer thickness or by cutting groups of suitable pitch. Metal film resistors. In this, the film usually consists of an alloy of tin and antimony metals. Its construction is similar to carbon film resistor. It is available as thin as thick film type resistors. Wire wound resistor. It is made by winding a single layer length of a special alloy wire in the form of a coil around an insulating core. It is used as an ultra-precision resistor in instrumentation and a power resistor in industrial applications. Variable resistors are those resistors whose resistance can be changed between 0 and a certain maximum value. They are used in electronic circuits to adjust the value of voltage and currents. They are used as volume control in a radio and a brightness control in television. Potentiometer. It is a variable resistor, either of carbon or wire wound type. It is manufactured either in film or molded track type. Both consist of an annular ring of carbon resistance formed on a plastic base over which a movable contact can slide. There is a slip ring which is contacted by the movable contact. Rheostat. A wire wound pot which can dissipate power more than 5 watt is known as a rheostat. It is made by winding a single length of a special alloy wire in the form of a coil around an open tube of ceramic which is covered with vitreous enamel. Except for the track of the movable contact, it can withstand temperature up to 300 degrees Celsius. It is used for high power applications such as control motor speed, welding current, and ovens. Trimmer. It is similar to potentiometer, but it is screw activated and the resistance can be adjusted by a screwdriver. In this resistor, the resistance track is made of carbon and ceramic. The carbon track along with the movable slide is housed in a steel casing. It is used where the resistance must be adjustable but not continuously variable. It is used in calibration and balancing of electronic equipment. Color coding of resistors. The carbon composition resistors have color bands on it, and these are coded to indicate the resistance value and tolerance of carbon composition resistor. Now I will move on the whiteboard to discuss about how can we find the value of a carbon composition resistor. We already know about what is carbon composition resistor and how it looks like. Suppose that I have a carbon composition resistor, and these are the color bands of this carbon composition resistor. This is a color coding table. In this color coding table are the band colors, and this is the value of first band, this is the value of second band, this is the value of multiplier band, and this is the value of tolerance. I have a carbon composition resistor having brown color, green color, orange color, and gold color bands. How can we find the value of this resistor? So come to the calculation part. First band is brown, second band is green, third band is orange, and fourth band is gold. So the value of brown color is 1 for first band. The value of green color is 5 for second band. And the third band, which is known as multiplier band, it is orange colored. For orange, 10 to the power 3 here. And gold is considered as tolerance band. So the value for gold color is plus minus 5%. Now I will write this expression in this form. 15 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 plus minus 5%. First I will find 5% of this value. I get 750. After that, one time this value will be added with this amount, and one time it will be subtracted, and then I will get this value. I will convert it into kilo ohm, 15.75 kilo ohm to 14.25 kilo ohm. Now I will verify this result by the help of digital multimeter. This is multimeter. These are three nodes of multimeter. This is a common node. This is a voltage node. These two nodes are connected by connecting leads. And here is a carbon composition resistor. This is a carbon composition resistor having four bands. One band is brown colored, another band is green colored, and third band is orange colored, and fourth band is golden colored. So now I will measure its value. I will set my digital multimeter in this ohm meter area on the 200 kilo ohm. So you can see here the value of this resistance is displayed on the screen, and it is nearer to 15 kilo ohm. In a resistor manufacturing industries, thousands of variety of resistors are made in a day. So it is very difficult to adjust every ordinary resistor to an exact value. For avoiding this difficulty, we provide tolerance to each ordinary resistor. Tolerance denotes the acceptable deviation in the resistance value of a resistor. The specified tolerances are 5%, 10%, and 20% for ordinary resistors, while precision resistors have a tolerance close to 0.1%. Now come to nonlinear resistors. Nonlinear resistors are those type of resistors which does not follow Ohm's law. Nonlinear resistors are of following types: thermistor resistor, photoresistor, it is also known as LDR, varistor resistor, and surface mount resistor. Thermistor resistor. You can see the figure of thermistor resistor on the screen. Thermistors are variable type resistors which senses the change in temperature. Its resistance is inversely proportional to the temperature. It is used for temperature regulation. Photoresistor. It is a light controlled variable resistor. Its resistance decreases with increase in incident light intensity. It is also called photoconductive cell. Varistor resistor. It is a two-terminal semiconductor device that protects the electrical and electronic devices from overloading of voltage. In varistor, current depends non-linearly on the applied voltage across it. Surface mount resistor. It is also called SMD. These are rectangular in shape. It is an electronic component that is made to use with the surface mount technology. In short, we can say that SMT technology.